So, with the puzzle, trying to visualize how to make a film about this rather dense topic was a confounding process. But I had worked with a local Vancouver director named Aaron Nathanson for some of the content for the special edition of the Empath record. And I convinced him and his crew to be involved with making the puzzle film. For the animators, I contacted a couple people. DC Turner, who had done the Y video, and his buddy Ricky, who is a great 3D animator, and Julius, whom I've mentioned before in this documentary, doing the fractal art. But filming this in Vancouver during the height of the pandemic was also really strange, really stressful. Like the precautions that we were taking and just everything that was involved with it was just not a simple process. Like everything else had been this year, it was complicated. And the filming was interesting as well, because obviously we didn't have a huge budget for this. So for the main actor, I hired me. And I have to admit, I'm probably not up for any Actor of the Year awards, but it was fun. But the point was important enough for me to try and make that I went with it. But the whole idea with the media, like the different types of media for Puzzle, was I wanted to have the theme represented by a lot of people, by different people. Now, all these pieces of media were coming together in a really cool way. The movie is super dark. The graphic novel is super dark. My sister's book is super dark. All these things were exactly as they were supposed to be. But I started recognizing as well that I didn't want to end this on a dark note, because that implied to me that there is no growth. So I started trying to write another piece of music on the side that would act as a sort of balm for the chaos that Puzzle was making me feel, like Alien and Synchestra, The Hummer and Dev Lab, Ocean Machine and City, Sky Blue and Dark Matters. I've been doing this forever. It helps me creatively to have something to sort of balance out the energy of one with the energy of another. So I started writing something really beautiful in the same sort of way that Puzzle had been built. I started another ambient jam, but this time with the intention of making something that people could put on if they were feeling stress, if they're feeling traumatic, if they're feeling like they have problems sleeping, something that will calm people down and make just something really beautiful that acts as a conclusion. If you were going through something that was really upsetting, I would like this record to be something you would listen to feel better. But the idea was to involve the same people who had worked on the puzzle in the same way. So this album then went out to the same group of musicians, and I started to really enjoy this one. I love the idea of not allowing that darkness to win you over. I love the idea of being able to face what we've had to face, and the conclusion, the solving of that puzzle, the recognition that the patterns internally that are creating such inner chaos are in many ways up to us to transcend. And by doing so, that was the whole point of this. Is that yes, it was chaos, and yes, it was dark, and yes, it was madness. But by recognizing how much control we actually have over our own minds and our own process, then we have the chance to react to things more so than trying to control them. And so the second project ended up being called, which is the most regrettable name ever, but because it elicited such a strong negative reaction from some of the people I knew that really like heavy music, I decided that yes, I was gonna call it Snuggles. And so the second record is called Snuggles, and this became a whole other thing. It became a whole other record, and then I wanted to make a film for that as well. And so the whole purpose of this project, of the puzzle, which is now two parts. The puzzle is Puzzle and Snuggles. It's two films, it's a graphic novel, it's a written novel, it has toys, it has characters, like this guy who's meant to represent the inner child that's being protected by these sentries of your ego, the guilt character, the thug, the id, the clergy, whatever it is. And so by the end of it, I decided to turn it into a complete box set. So something that could take this whole pandemic era and all the creative chaos that ensued during it, put it all in one place and create a monument of this pandemic that I can look back on creatively and say, okay, this is what it was for me. Here are all these people that I care about. Here's this movie about it. Here's this visualizer. Here's this book. Here's this toy. Here's this, you know, in the box that we've got a video screen. I just really wanted to do this, and I wanted it to be awesome. I mean, I'm constantly sort of asked to make things simpler or to try and present things to people in a way that's more accessible. And although I do like that type of music, for sure, that's not what the pandemic was for me. The pandemic was a test for me, for all the people that I knew, for so many people that I cared about. It's an experience that I think it's really important to not forget and to not gloss over and to be in denial of how difficult it was. Because the only way we can grow is by being able to look at it and really say, yeah, this is what I learned. This is who I am. This is what came out of this. This is where my weaknesses are. These are where my strengths are. How much negative self-talk prevents us from actually taking that step? Like, how much of our unwillingness to fail prevents us from putting ourselves in any position where we risk failure? It's so much easier to criticize and never try than it is to try and risk that failure. But I'll tell you what, man, the success lies on the other side of the risk of being viewed as a failure. So the puzzle was my pandemic art project. And there we go. I thank everybody who was involved. I thank you for all your participation during the quarantine concerts and the podcasts and everything. And I look forward to seeing you on tour. And now I'm actually recording a new record. The record I'm working on now is called Lightwork. And it comes out first quarter of 2022. And Lightwork is a bunch of songs. It's not an abstract record. It's a really strong, direct, more accessible record, I guess. But I wouldn't have had the opportunity to do that had I not cleared the pipes of the chaos that has happened to me and to everybody I know with the puzzle. So it may not be your cup of tea musically. I can accept that. But really, I thank you so much for the opportunity to be able to do this. Holy cow. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. If there's anything that comes from the puzzle for me, it's just thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Take care of yourselves, all right? See you around.